And finally, I think the outrage is even worse when they say, you know, they show the hangars and all that, you know, and that this is how people die, this is how people die. Well, you know, I don't want to get into, you know, when does life begin and all that, although you did reference it, Jesse, and I think most people would agree with the, you know, the first, second, and third trimester, the way you analyzed it. But you want to know, you want to use a hanger? How about you take a picture of an abortion, of a fetus being pulled apart? Let's not go there. Let's try to have an intelligent discussion.
Okay, Pirro is doing her best, wine allowing, to engage in an intelligent discussion. But think about what she just said there. She said in response to, as we were talking about earlier on the show in a different clip, that there's imagery of coat hangers that are used at some of these protests. Obviously a reminder of the fact that you cannot in practice get rid of abortion. You can only make it illegal, and thus something that has to happen outside of the law, which is inherently more dangerous, which will result in people dying. So she doesn't like that. So she tries to do the thing that anti-abortion protesters have done for a very long time, creating some sort of equivalence to just show photos of fetuses or whatever, and that'll be the same thing. Now, of course, she is missing that one is a substantive reminder and the other is pure imagery. But also, we have been doing that for decades, Jeanine Pirro. People like you have been trying to use images like that to get people to accept these insane restrictions on people's autonomy and freedom. How has that worked out for you? Would you like to look at a poll? Has that been persuasive to people? I went to UT Austin. I couldn't walk on the outside of the campus without some whack jobs yelling Bible quotes with big signs that have fetuses on them. I remain committed to people's reproductive freedoms. And so, like, that's a BS argument, obviously, yes. But I do like that you can see her getting uncomfortable about the reminders of the coat hangers. Like, I think that they are demonstrating, whether they know or not, that they get that this is a weakness, that people understand the very real world stakes in this issue.
Yeah, that's exactly what it is that the image of the coat hanger is actually what will and has happened in the past when we didn't have women's reproductive freedoms, right? And they don't want to talk about that. They don't want to talk about the fact that the United States has one of the highest, I think the highest infant mortality rate in, you know, in the developed world, right? And we also have a very high rate of mothers who die in labor, right? And they're not talking about those things. And then on top of that, on top of all of that that we already have to deal with in this country, and that's with whatever institutionalized healthcare we already have for mothers and their infants, if you take away reproductive freedoms, now those coat hangers are going to become more of a viable solution to women who can't go to a doctor. And we have no healthcare in this country. We have really bad healthcare in this country, I'll say. So, I mean, it really is a reality that the right is not wanting to acknowledge because it's not going to go in their favor.
Yeah, I am 100%. And they're very clear about that. They were just big, tough, big dogs leading up to it actually being announced that it's going to be reverse. Now it's all, well, don't freak out. I mean, nothing's really gonna change. Oh God, don't remind us of what's gonna happen. Like, they're all of a sudden very scared about the entire thing. Anyway, but we can't let us fool us that we, as of right now, have lost. The reasons we've lost are complicated, multifaceted. There's a lot of blame to go around on why we ended up in the position we're in, and a lot of work to be done to get us out of that position once again. The fact that they might suffer a little bit electorally in the midterms as a result of this, and even that is not guaranteed, that does not equal things out. It's not even Stevens because they don't get one or two House seats or whatever. For more political news breakdowns, interviews, stories of activism, and me trying my hardest to care about the occasional big celebrity news story, subscribe to our YouTube channel at youtube.com/thedamagereport. And you can ring the bell wherever it is, so you don't miss anything.